Dear all students, in previous lecture we have studied up to the topic of classification of control systems. So the classification were explained, and now we will move forward towards an open loop and closed loop system. So we will understand about an open loop and closed loop system. Now here you can see the figure of open loop control system. As the name suggests, open loop means the loop is not closed, it is open. So the system is not having a feedback from output to the input. You can see any physical system which does not automatically correct for the variation in its output is called as an open loop system. So in order to understand it easily, means the system which is not having a connection between its input and output, no feedback loop is there, that means it is open loop system. Okay, see, in this system the output is dependent on the input, but controlling action or input is totally independent of the output. Means whatever the input you give, the output will be, you can say, is dependent on that input. Okay, in these systems the output remains constant for constant input signal provided. The external condition remains unaltered, means the part of output is not fed back to the input. So this is an open loop control system, a system which is having an open loop. Okay. So the advantages of that open loop control systems are, you can say, system are very simple in construction, very much convenient. System are easily, maintenance point of view, they are very easy. Disadvantage is these systems are inaccurate and unreliable. Okay. This system cannot sense any disturbance. Okay. Recalibration of the controller is very necessary. So time to time to maintain that quality and accuracy of desired output. Now, what are the examples of the open loop system? The one is, number one is automatic toaster system. So if you are having a toaster at your home, so in general in today's toaster you are having a heating element which is having a knob. So one knob is between 1 to 10 or 1 to 5. So if you put on one, the toaster will heat, for example, to 30 seconds. If you put on two, it will heat for 60 seconds. If you put on three, so it will heat it for 90 seconds. So you have to check in that to eject the bread, so that the toaster does not overheat your bread. Okay. So it does not check the quality of bread and after it automatically pulls the bread out. So this is an open loop system. Okay. See, desired power input, heating process of bread and actual toast. Finally, it is up to you. You have to keep your eyes as a feedback element to see whether the bread is being properly baked or not. Okay. Toaster will have nothing to do with that. Toaster will only heat it irrespective of the bread, whether it is overheated or underheated. So this is the best example of your open loop system. Now moving towards the best example is traffic light controller. Okay, lights does not have any relation with the ongoing traffic. It is dependent upon the program, which LED will blink red for certain second, green for certain second. Okay, so that is an open loop system. This loop has nothing to do with the traffic. Okay, it is just showing, directing the traffic where to go and where to stop. Third example is your residential heating system. Okay, so it is up to the indoor temperature that response is variable of interest. It is affected by the main disturbance, the outdoor temperature. Okay, so the valve is the valve dial is calibrated when the environment temperature has a certain value. Now, as we have studied up to open loop system, so in open loop system we were having a system which is not having any feedback. Okay, so in closed loop system the loop is closed, the feedback system is there. So a definition says that a system that maintains a prescribed relationship between the output and the reference input by comparing them and using the difference as a means of control is called as a feedback control system. Means the difference again is fed back to the input, and on the basis of that input, on the basis of the difference signal, the input will be recalibrated and again given to the system. So this is known as your feedback control system. Feedback control system are often referred as a closed loop control system. So in practice, the term feedback control and a closed loop control are used interchangeably. Okay. Now, actuating error signal is the heart of a closed loop or a feedback control system. So this will reduce you, or this will vary your input parameter, which will vary directly your output parameter. Okay. So closed loop control system, you can see the figure is command input, reference transducer. This is the reference input, and here you can see the control element, controller, process to be controlled, and directly feedback element. See, RT is your reference input, ET is your error signal, CT is your controlled output, that is output, and MT is your manipulated signal, and FB is your feedback signal. Now, closed loop control system, you can see the part of output is decided where the element is fed back to the reference input. It is then compared with the reference input giving error signal ET, RT plus minus of BT. So the error signal is then modified by controller and decides the proportional manipulated signal for the process to be controlled. Okay. So the error signal ET and the manipulated signal finally will control the process. So the advantage is always very high because controller modifies, manipulates the actuating signal so that we will get the desired output. Okay. Now disadvantage we are having is the system will be very complicated and time consuming while designing point of view. Once it is being designed, it will provide more advantage. But designing of the closed loop or a feedback control system is going to take a time consuming and a process oriented work. Now, what is an example? Best example is your human being. So the eyes will act as a feedback loop, hands and brain will act as a your input reference position. For example, if the book is placed away, so you know how much steps to move, and your eyes will give that feedback signal, okay, your hands are away from the book. If you touch it, your eyes will give, okay, it is touched, now hold the book. So the best example is your human being. Second is the home heating system. Now your desired control system will be feedback loop will be given to temperature sensor while heating system will heat it. This heating system is not having any control over itself, so it will heat. Okay, now temperature sensor will sense and give it once it reaches the desired temperature, the error signal will be given to control element and the valve will be closed. Means your valve will close and your heating system will not get its input, so it will slow down. So that we will attain the desired temperature. Second is your manual speed control system. Okay, now manual speed control system is if you are driving a vehicle, so you are the what you can say feedback control system, you are the control element, you will see the road ahead and you will press the accelerator. Okay, if the car is ahead or you will press the brakes. Okay, so it is up to you how much speed you are going to apply and how much speed you are going to slow down. So this is the example of a manual speed control system. Now what are the basic difference versus open loop and closed loop? So any change in output has no effect on the input, as in open loop. Output change of output will not have any effect on input. Whereas on the contrast, the closed loop will have effect on its input. So output measurement is not required for operation of system. But in closed loop, the output is necessary. Feedback element is absent, and in closed loop, the feedback element is present. In open loop, the error detector is absent, and in closed loop, the error detector is necessary. It is inaccurate and unreliable. Open, highly accurate and reliable. Highly sensitive to disturbances in open loop, and in closed loop you can see as the control element is there, it is less sensitive to disturbances. Now open loop is highly sensitive to the environmental changes, while closed loop is less sensitive to environmental changes. As in open loop you are having a bandwidth is small, the bandwidth is large in closed loop, simple to construct and cheap, while as discussed earlier, the closed loop will be complicated to design and hence it is costly. generally are stable in nature, while stability is a major consideration while designing the closed loop. System stability is a major important point while you are designing a feedback control system. Now, highly affected by non-linearities and reduced effect of non-linearities. So, what are the requirements of an ideal control system? So, ideal control system, there are basically two requirements. One, accuracy and sensitivity. So, that control system must be accurate and it must be sensitive. So, good control system should be very sensitive to environmental changes. Okay. Number third is external disturbance or noise. Means, this subjected to external disturbance, noise, it must cancel, or requirement of very good control system is that system is insensitive, means it will not be affected by the external interference. Finally, the main thing is stability. Instability means the output of a system must follow a reference input and must produce a bounded output. For an bounded input means your system must not be an instable or marginal. A good control system is one which is stable in nature. Bandwidth, speed must be, it should react suddenly for the changes in the control element. Oscillations, damping oscillation must be provided for the system. Hence, we have studied all the basic introduction requirement of your ideal control system. Hope you have understood. Thank you.